Welcome back. Let's start with several improvements. First of all, it is time to upgrade our project's .NET framework version. I chose 3.5 so that this time my program could launch on Windows XP. But any upgrade will drop Windows XP anyway. The last version of .NET framework is 4.8. But if we upgrade to 4.6.1, our program can work on Windows 8. Secondly, let's update the copyright. Thirdly, don't forget to update the program's version. Changing .NET framework version is a more than sufficient reason to do this. Also, I'm going to create a separate folder for images. Finally, I have prepared a new icon. Let's change our project's icon to it. And build the project to make sure everything is fine. Seems like that. Now let's make our program multilingual. Right-click on your resources folder. Select Add Resource Dictionary. It is going to be an XAML file. I will name it String Resources. Here you first remove the local namespace, and then you add system namespace to use string type in XAML. Now we can place system string tags inside of it. They all need X key, so that we can access them in our windows. This resource dictionary will be used to store English labels. Now we need to include this resource dictionary in our app.xaml file. In your application resources, create a new tag called resource dictionary. We need to modify its merge dictionaries property. In future, we are going to use global styles as well, so let's leave a reminder comment. Finally, we put another resource dictionary tag here, this time with its source specified. To make our program multilingual, we just need to duplicate our string resources. I recommend adding language culture after the dot to its name. We have duplicated it because we need the same keys for strings. The only thing that we need to change is the text in the string tag. I will just translate English words into German. Dear German-speaking viewers, if you see errors, please let me know in the comments to this video, because I am not a native German speaker. It's better to make one improvement now. We need to create a folder for Windows. And place our main window inside of it. Because the path to the window has changed, we need to update the startup URI property in app.xaml. Now let's view the main Windows code. I'm going to create a new method to set language dictionary of the program. This method will accept the needed culture as a string. First, create and initialize a new resource dictionary. Then check the culture for possible values. For American English, use en-us. If this is the best culture, then we need to set the source of the resource dictionary to the first XAML file. For German, use de-de. If it is German, then we need to set the source of the resource dictionary to the second XAML file. If anything different was passed to this method, I will set the American English string resources. And finally, you need to add this new resource dictionary to the merge dictionaries property of your app. Now we need a control to switch languages. Before we do that, I recommend making the structure of our design easier to handle. First of all, instead of three separate columns, we are going to have a column for presets and a column for the timer. The first column will consist of two rows, one for presets, the other for controls to switch languages. The first row will be a grid consisting of two columns for presets. Set grid row to 0. Give it a name. I'm going to also disable it by default, because presets will be available only with the valid license key. Create two column definitions, both of which need to have width set to auto. Now just move group boxes inside this new grid. In the second row, we are going to have a stack panel for language controls. The first element inside stack panel will be a grid for changing the language manually. This grid is going to have four columns of different widths. Let's start with the last column, because I am going to place a button to switch to German there. Now pay attention to how you need to reference the needed key. Since resource dictionary is used dynamically, in curly braces you type dynamic resource, then goes the needed key. This way, the text is not hard-coded and always gets the current value of the string with the specified key. Now let's create a click event for German button. Here we simply call our method and pass the German culture. Let's see if the tooltip of the button will change after we press the button. Okay, back to the designer. Now let's create a similar button for English. Again, let's create a click event for English button. And again we call our method and pass the American English culture. Let's see if we can change the language to German and back to English. So it works as intended. A very useful feature would be to detect the language automatically. The only difference is that you pass the current culture to the method. As you see, automatic detection switches to English. But if I check my OS culture, you will see that it is not English nor German but Ukrainian. That's because when I pass any culture for which I don't have a separate option, it changes to American English by default. So now you know how to make your program multilingual and automatically detect the language.